Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 14-20 that is taken from chapter number 14, Energy Methods, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbler. So statement is: the concrete column consists 6 1-inch diameter steel reinforcing rod. If the column supports a load of 300 kips, determine the strain energy in the column. E of steel is 29 × 10⁻³ KSI, while E of concrete is 3.6 × 10�³ KSI. So you can see this is the concrete column that consists of this 1-inch steel rod, and the load that it supports is 300 kips. So you have to find the strain energy in this column. So let's start with the solution. So first step is that if you cut this column and draw the free body diagram. So let me draw it first. Let this is the frontal view of this column. There is a load of 300 axial load, which is acting 300 kips, clear? And you can see that this load is acting on this concrete column. So some of load is taken by concrete and some of the load is taken by this steel reinforcing rod. So I will write, as a result, this load will be equal to P of concrete, and some of the load is taken by P of steel. So we will apply equilibrium condition in order to write the equation. So this is the equation: that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to zero and upward forces taken as positive. So you can see minus 300, which is downward, plus P of concrete plus P of steel is equal to zero. So from here we can say that P of concrete plus P of steel is equal to 300. It means that this 300 kips load is taken, some of portion is taken by concrete while some is taken by this steel rod. So this is your, that this is your equation number one. Now you can see that due to this load, there will be deformation in this concrete as well as in this steel rod. Since both are same, both are joined with each other, so their deflection will be same. So we will write compatibility equation. So compatibility equation, which is equal to change in length of concrete is equal to change in length of steel. Okay, as we know that change in length is equal to P into L divided by AE, that this change in length is due to axial load, clear? So for concrete, I will write P of concrete into length, both lengths are same, divided by, I will write it, length of concrete is equal to length of steel, and that is equal to L, divided by area of concrete into E of concrete, that will be equal to P of steel into L of steel, which is equal to L, divided by area of steel into modulus of elasticity of steel. So you can see this LL will cancel with each other, so we will left with P of concrete divided by area of concrete into EC is equal to PS divided by AS into ES. Now we will calculate this area of concrete. So area of concrete, you can see this is the area. The diameter is given, the radius is given as 12 inch. So radius of concrete is given as 12 inch, clear? So there are six 1-inch diameter steel rods. So this area of concrete will be equal to this minus the area of this steel, six steel rods. So I will write area of concrete is pi r square, rc square, minus 6 times the area of steel rod. So area of steel rod is 6 multiplied by pi r s square, clear? Now what is this? So pi, area of radius of concrete is given as 12. So pi 12 square minus 6 times pi. What is diameter of steel rod is given as 1 inch. So radius will be 0.5. So 0.5 square. So this is the area of concrete. Now area of steel is equal to pi r square. Pi r s square. So that is equal to pi multiplied by 0.5 square. Since there are 6 rods, so I will multiply by 6 multiply by on both sides. Clear? So now you can put the value P of concrete divided by area of concrete is pi into 12 square minus 6 times pi into 0.5 square. Multiply by E of steel, E of concrete, which is 3.6 into 10 to the power 3. So 3.6 into 10 to the power 3. That will be equal to P of steel divided by area of steel is 6 into pi into 0.5 square. And what about E? E of steel is also given as 29 into 10 to the power 3 KSI. So I will write 29 into 10 to the power 3 KSI. Okay, so when you solve this, P of concrete will be equal to 11.7931 P of steel. Here, let this is your equation number 2. Now put the value of P of concrete in equation number 1. So put equation 2 in equation 1. So P of concrete is 11.7931 PS plus PS is equal to 300. What I did is that I replace P of concrete with its value and P of steel was there. So their sum must be equal to 300. Okay. Now when you solve this, it will be, from here you will get P of steel will be equal to 23.45 kip. So out of 300 kip steels, each steel rod takes 23.45 kips load. This is equation number 3. Now put equation 3 in equation 2. So P of concrete is equal to 11.7931 into P of steel, so which is 23.45 kip, and you will get P of concrete will be equal to 276.55 kip. Okay, so it means that concrete is taking 276.55 kip load, while the six steel rods are taking 23.45 kips load. Now you have all the loads, so we will find the strain energy due to axial loading, that is equal to sum of n square L divided by 2 AE R. We have written here P, so it will be equal to sum of P square L divided by 2 AE. So just put the values. So I will write it for P of concrete square into length divided by area of concrete into EC plus P square of steel into L divided by 2 times E of area of steel. So there are 6 steels, so I will write 6 multiplied by AS into E of steel. Now put the value, so you will get U strain energy due to axial loading will be equal to P of concrete is 276.55 square multiplied by length. We will check the length. Length is 5 feet. So in inch, it will be 60 inch. 12 into 5. We'll convert it to into inch. 2 multiplied by area of concrete, which is again this one. Clear? So I will write it. Pi into 12 square minus 6 multiplied by pi into 0.5 square into E of C, which is 3.6 into 10 to the power 3 plus P of steel, which was 23.45 into length is 5 feet. So 5 into 12 will give you in inch. Divide by 2, and area of steel, 6 steel rod is this one. So 6 multiplied by pi into 0.5 square multiplied by E of steel, which was 29 into 10 raised to power 3 KSI. So when you solve this, you will get strain energy due to this axial loading will come out to be 1.544 kips into inch. And if you want to convert it into feet, you have to divide it by 12. So you will get 0.129 kip into feet. And this, which is the answer of our this question. And that was all about this problem 14-20. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Also share my videos with your friends and help me in growing further. Thank you for watching.